Good morning, and welcome to Ephesians of Richmond Sunday morning virtual worship service. We invite you to experience the worship, experience the glory, and experience the praise with us as we lift up the name of Jesus today.
We pray peace.
Oh,
in this time of fighting.
In this time of fighting.
We pray love.
Love.
In this time of hating.
In this time of hating.
We pray safety.
We pray safety.
In this time.
In this time of killing,
the joy of the Lord,
send joy, God.
In this time of stressing,
in this time of stressing,
we pray Goshen,
Goshen,
Goshen.
It's God's protection.
Almighty.
Oh,
God's protection.
Let's say it again, y'all. Come on.
We pray peace.
We pray peace.
In this time of fighting.
In this time of fighting.
We pray love.
Pray safety for you and your family.
The joy of the Lord.
The joy of the Lord.
In this time of stressing.
In this time of stressing.
We pray Goshen.
When we pray Goshen,
Goshen.
We're praying protection.
Greetings. I'm Pastor Lewis B. Spicer, Jr., pastor of the Ephesians of Richmond, Church of God in Christ, in the city of Richmond, California. As we celebrate civil rights and the birth of Dr. Martin Luther King Jr., we want to be reminded of all the battles and struggles fought with blood, sweat, and tears in the name of freedom was not just for African Americans, but for all people. With all the civil chaos demonstrated during this time in the United States, let us remember that the forefathers of this nation stated, we hold these truths to be self-evident, that all men are created equal, that they are endowed by their Creator with certain unalienable rights, that among these are life, liberty, and pursuit to happiness. Although these words were intended for them only, this nation must be reminded that these words hold true for all men. Let us never forget the civil rights movement and never forget Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. Today, we celebrate civil rights. Go with us into worship that is in progress.
Hallelujah. Bless the name of Jesus. Come on and help me magnify him this grand Sunday morning. Come on and praise him and lift him up. Exalt his name on high. We love you, Lord. We love you. Hallelujah. And we bless your name on today. We glorify you because you're so worthy. Worthy is your name. You're so honorable on today. We thank you, Lord. We just come to praise and magnify your name. Oh, we come to lift you up, oh God. Hallelujah. You're magnified in this place on today. Glory to your wondrous name. Thank you, Lord. Thank you. Hallelujah. Bless your name, oh God. We thank you on this Sunday morning. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Come on, saints, and help me praise him. Hallelujah. Praise him right now. We thank you, oh God. You're wonderful. Hallelujah. We're just praying for the sick on this morning, for those who are on their sick beds and in the hospital right now and can't move right now. Oh, we just praise God for your healing right now, for the creative miracles that he's doing in your bodies right now. We thank you, God. We praise you for your healing virtue that's touching those that's in the jail houses, behind bars right now, behind prison walls right now. We glorify you, oh God. You're so wonderful. We thank you right now. Hallelujah. As your healing power leaves your body right now, how your spirit would touch those from the crown of their heads to the soles of their feet right now. We thank you, Lord. Hallelujah, we praise you. We receive that healing right now. We receive wholeness in our bodies right now. In the mighty name of Jesus, because we know there's power in your name. There's healing in your name. your name on this morning. And we glorify you for that. Hallelujah, we lift you up and thank you because you healed our bodies over 2,000 years ago. Oh, we praise you this morning. Hallelujah, we dance in your presence right now. We sing in your presence because we're praising and glorifying you for our healing right now. By faith, we have it right now. In the mighty name of Jesus, we thank you, oh God. Hallelujah, we appreciate you. We adore you. Thank you for the spirit of healing right now. Thank you that we walk in divine health right now. Oh, we praise you, oh God, for being Jehovah Rapha right now, the God that healeth thee. Hallelujah, we praise you right now. We receive it, and it's done. And your name will be ever more magnified and edified this morning. In Jesus' name, amen, 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 and so be it.
We praise you, Lord. We bless you. You are God, and we are your people. Of every nation, kindred, and tongue, black, white, we are your people, and we declare that you are good. Even in stressful times, hallelujah, we're gonna be faithful in our praise, hallelujah. Because you're faithful in your grace. Thank you, Lord. Thank you. Declare it with us. Say you are good. Hallelujah. You are good. Right where you are. Come on, say it. You are good. Hallelujah. You are good. No matter what it feels. Lord, we declare, hallelujah, you are good. Everybody raise it up, say you are good. Hallelujah, you are good. Everybody, everywhere, say you. You are good. Hey, you. Oh. not be saying this, but you need to declare it anyway. Because God is faithful. Hallelujah. You are good. Come on. You might be sick in your body, but God is our healer. And just say, you are good.
Found in 2 Chronicles 20:1 through 4. If you have 2 Chronicles 20:1 through 4. And it came to pass after this that the children of Moab and the children of Ammon, and with them other besides the Ammonites, came against Jehoshaphat to battle. Then there came some that told Jehoshaphat, saying, there cometh a great multitude against thee from beyond the sea on the side of Syria. And behold, they be in Hazazon Tamar and in Engedi. And Jehoshaphat feared and set himself to seek the Lord and proclaimed a fast throughout all Judah. And Judah gathered themselves together to ask help of the Lord. Even out of all the cities of Judah, they came to seek the Lord. My subject, amen, to you today is in the heat of injustice and chaos. When injustice fall upon you, there is no time to react hastily, but it is time, the best time, to think wisely and move with integrity. And in all causes of default against you, you should pray. It was Job that said, "My face is foul with weeping, and my eyelids is the shadow of death, not for any injustice in my hands. Also, my prayer is pure." When no one else will believe your story, you have to stand on unfeigned faith. Believe and trust that God will make a way when confronted with injustice. I say this today as the United States is up against numerous catastrophic events, chaos and disorder, a siege against the national government and Capitol Hill. Civil unrest and fear lie upon the hearts of minorities of this nation due to evil, hatred, and racism. We have an evangelical church that supposedly stands on the premises of Christian ethics, that thou shalt not kill, but cry that those who support Democrat are killers. We have an evangelical church that stands on the premises of Christian ethics against same-sex marriage is wrong, and it is wrong, but they stand on the premises of injustice and hate acts of people upon people of color. This is the same evangelical church that after these catastrophic events this past week may end up returning to their white hoods and red crosses and riding in the streets, pumping fear and spreading hate across the nation. The evangelical church is the same church that comes to you dressed as a wolf in sheep clothing, deceiving the people, upholding the golden rule and the words of Christ. "By this shall all men know that ye are my disciples, if ye love one to another." This is the same church that teaches Christ's words. "If a man say, I love God and hateth his brother, he is a liar. For he that loveth not his brother whom he hath seen, how can he love God whom he hath not seen? And this commandment have ye from him, that he who loveth God love his brother also." This is the same church that teaches Christ's words, "Beloved, let us love one another. For love is of God, and everyone that loveth is born of God and knoweth God. He that loveth not knoweth not God, for God is love." How in the world can you exhibit God's love but hate your neighbor who is black, Indian, Asian, and Arab, or Muslim? Have hatred and wants to cut them off of this nation. However, we must handle cases of injustice with integrity. For Zephaniah 3 and 5 says that the just Lord is in the midst thereof, and he will not do iniquity. Every morning doth he bring his judgment to light. He faileth not. But the unjust knoweth no shame, and certainly there is no shame in their actions. The actions of those that seize the Capitol has no shame. They have no shame in their hatred, racism, and motive to make America great again. People, do not be fooled for the statement, "Make America Great Again." Is making America great is for white supremacists who feels that they are losing the grasp of control of this nation, in which they are aliens and immigrants and stole this land from the people whom were here before them. There are people who call the Capitol and the White House their house, taking their house back when it was built upon the backs of African slaves. What makes their actions just Satan has blinded the eyes and darkened the hearts of such people. For the word of God even says in Amos 5 and 12, "For I know your manifold transgressions and your mighty sins. They afflict the just. They take a bribe and they turn aside the poor in the gate from their right." Two wrongs don't make a right, even in cases of racism and prejudices. People of God, you have to be wise in your actions, not to be a victim of circumstances and be a number of the status quo. Wake up and see that there are evils that lark against you. Wake up and drop the scales from your eyes, and if you have been suppressed by such philosophy and behavior, resist the evils and walk in integrity. Living this life as a Christian every day, even though it becomes sweeter as the day goes by, we will learn that everyday living is a battleground. And we will have to fight to survive with integrity. For Timothy even wrote in 1 Timothy 6 and 12, "Fight the good fight of faith and lay hold on eternal life, whereunto thou art also called and hast professed a good profession before many witnesses." Isn't it strange that most people keep fighting a losing battle? They never choose to fight for the right or just causes. Trouble is everywhere, and you have to be watchful. For everyday living is a battle. You have to fight to get up in the morning. It's a battle, yes. You have to fight and struggle with what you eat, yes. Because sometimes they say something is good for you, and next thing you know, praise the Lord, amen, that is not good for you. You have to fight to get a job, and then once you get the job, you have to fight, amen, to keep the job. And then you have to fight to go to work. You have to fight, amen, to raise your children, and you have to fight to pay your bills, and you have to fight not to lose your composure when tempted, and even you have to fight to stay safe, and you have to fight to stay sane. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. For God's word says that wherefore take unto you the whole armor of God, that ye may be able to withstand in the evil day, and having done all, to stand. But what do you do when you don't feel like fighting? Many times we find ourselves in the midst of battles, and the struggle of the battle just zaps your strength. And you find yourselves willing to go up in the midst of the battle, and you no longer want to fight. But just remember that God is a will. Yes, yes, he is a will in the middle of a will. And wherever you may find yourself, there is a will and there is a way. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Here we find the people of God in the same situation. Hallelujah. There will be times, amen, as soldiers, amen, for the Lord, that there will be battles we will have to fight. And there will be times as soldiers, amen, of the Lord, that there will be battles you will not have to fight. For Ephesians 6 says, "Finally, my brethren, be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might, and put on the whole armor of God, that ye may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. For we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities and powers and rulers, amen, of the darkness of this world, against spirituality and wickedness in high places. Wherefore, take unto you the whole armor of God, that ye may be able to withstand in the evil day. And having done all, to stand. And stand therefore, having your loins gird about with truth, and having the breastplate of righteousness, and your feet shod with the preparation of the gospel of peace, and above all, taking the shield of faith, wherewith ye shall be able to quench all the fiery darts of the wicked. And take the helmet of salvation and the sword of the Spirit, which is the word of God. But when there is no strength to fight, hallelujah, thank you, Jesus, all you will have to do is just lift up your head and sing a praise and just lift up those hands and just wave your hand and just bless the name of the Lord. Just put a praise on your tongue. Put a praise on your lips. Put a praise down in your spirit. Put a praise in your heart and just lift up your heads and just give God the glory and give God the praise. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Israel was against a battle that zapped their strength. And for the Bible says that it came to pass after this that the children of Moab and the children of Ammon and with them other besides the Ammonites came against Jehoshaphat to battle. And Jehoshaphat was burdened with trouble within his heart because the enemy had already made an approach into the camp. So he set himself in preparation to seek the Lord for strength, favor, and an answer to his problem. And he proclaimed a fast among the entire camp of men and women and children. For God, a man says that men ought to always pray and not to faint. Yes, yes. Even in the situations, I mean, we've seen that we our backs up against the wall. If there's nothing else to do, all we got to do is call on the name of Jesus. They said, call him in the morning, call him in the noonday, call him in the evening. You can call him all 24/7, call him all day long. Call on the name of Jesus. If you call on his name, surely he will answer. Hallelujah. For he answers prayers. Hallelujah. He's a prayer answering God. He's a God. Hallelujah. Amen. That no matter what's going on, he will come to your rescue. Hallelujah. If you believe that, just begin to put your hands together and give God some glory and give God some praise. And whatever that situation may be, just call on the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. For the Bible says that Jehoshaphat, amen, the king prayed and he prayed, amen, from his voice, O Lord God of our fathers, art thou not thou God in heaven and rulest now thou over all the kingdoms of the heathen? And in thy hand is there not power and might so that none is able to withstand thee? Hallelujah. Or not thou our God who didst drive out the inhabitants of the land before thy people Israel and gavest to the seed of Abraham thy friend forever? For they dwell therein and have built thee a sanctuary therein for thy name, saying, if when evil cometh up upon us, as the sword and judgment and or pestilence or famine, we stand before this house and in thy presence, for thy name is in this house, and cry unto thee in our affliction, then thou wilt hear our help. Hallelujah. And now behold, the children of Ammon and Moab and Mount Seir come. Thou wouldest not that let Israel invade when they came out of the land of Egypt, but they turned from them and destroyed them not. But behold, I say, they reward us to come to cast us out of thy possession, which thou hast given us to inherit. O our God, hallelujah, wilt thou not judge them? Hallelujah. For we have no might against this great company that cometh up against us. neither know we what to do, but our eyes are upon thee. Thank you, Jesus. In times of despair, and you don't know what to do, turn and lift up your head towards the Lord, hallelujah, and say, Lord, although I may have no might against this thing, but eyes are upon thee. So in times of despair, put your eyes on the Lord. And then when the Bible says God spoke to the congregation, then the Bible says that then Jehaziel, the son of Zechariah, a Levite of the sons of Asaph, they came to the Spirit of the Lord in the midst of the congregation. And he said, hearken ye, all Judah, and ye inhabitants of Jerusalem, and thou King Jehoshaphat, thus said the Lord unto you, be not afraid, nor be dismayed by reason of this multitude. For the battle is not yours, but it's God's. Hallelujah. That's what you got to do sometimes when you find yourself up against, hallelujah, the enemy, when he's coming like a mushing riding wind. You got to look up your eyes toward the hills from which cometh your help, knowing that your help cometh from the Lord. And just lift up your hands and say, the battle is not yours, but it is God's. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. And the Spirit of the Lord came and said, tomorrow go ye down against them. And behold, they come up by the cliff of Ziz. And ye shall find them at the end of the brook, before the wilderness of Jeruel. And ye shall need not to fight in this battle, but set yourselves and stand ye still and see the salvation of the Lord that will be with you. O Judah and of Jerusalem, fear not nor be dismayed, for tomorrow go out against them, for the Lord will be with you. Hallelujah. And the Bible goes on and it says that, hallelujah, that Jehoshaphat and the entire congregation, they bowed their heads and their faces to the ground, and they worshiped God. And they rose up early in the morning and took the camp and went forth into the wilderness of Tekoa. And there he consulted with them, and he appointed singers that they should praise the beauty of God's holiness. Thank you, Jesus. And so they stood at the cliff, hallelujah, and they sang, praise the Lord, for his mercy endureth forever. Thank you, Jesus. We got to know that God's mercy is everlasting, and his truth, hallelujah, endureth to all generations. And when they began to sing unto the Lord, God, hallelujah, set forth an ambushment. Thank you, Jesus. And he brought forth confusion amongst all of their enemies. Oh, thank you, Jesus. For they found themselves there at the brook, hallelujah, at the cliff before the valley. Thank you, Jesus. And Jehoshaphat lined them up. Thank you, Jesus. And he pointed singers one by one in the name of Jesus to sing the praises of the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, bless his name. And as they begin to open up their mouths, as they begin to cry unto the Lord, they begin to cry, praise the Lord for his mercy endureth forever. And as they praise the Lord, as they begin to cry unto the Lord, as they begin to lift up his holy name, as they begin to exalt the name of the Lord, as they begin to sing forth all the praises, oh, bless his name, their enemy, hallelujah, God sent forth a spirit upon them, and they begin to turn one towards another, and they begin to fight against themselves. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, bless his name. Oh, bless his name. We got to know that our praise is our way out. Our praise is how we shall be delivered. It's our praise that calls on the name of the Lord. It's our praise that shall be our deliverance. It's our praise that shall heal us. Thank you, Jesus. It's our praise, oh, bless his name, that shall be our Redeemer. Thank you, Jesus. We got to be minded that your praise is your weapon, and that no matter what's going on, no matter what the enemy may be doing, no matter what the enemy may attempt to do, you just lift up your hands and begin to praise unto the Lord. Your enemies, they got to die. Yes, they do. Oh, bless his name. Oh, bless his name. Just call on the name. Call on the name. Call on the name of the Lord. For he is a strong tower. A strong tower. Therewith the righteous run in and they are saved. Oh, bless his name. No matter what you're going through, just sing a praise. Just sing alone unto the Lord. All ye people, sing unto the Lord with gladness. Sing unto the Lord with praise. Sing unto the Lord with thanksgiving. Sing unto the Lord, and he will come to your rescue. Oh, yes, he will. Oh, bless his name. Be reminded that your praise is your weapon. And if you praise him, oh, praise the Lord. If you pray, if you fast, if you call on the name of the Lord, something's got to happen. If you call on the name of the Lord, something begins to stir up on the inside. Oh, bless his name. If you praise him, lift up a praise unto the Lord. He will make a way. He'll make a way of escape. Thank you, Jesus. He opened up the doors. He opened wide an open door by which you can stand and you can escape your fiery darts. Thank you, Jesus. Yes. Lift up your heads. All ye gates, be ye lifted, ye everlasting doors, and the King of glory, the King of glory, he'll come in. If you praise him, he'll come in. If you lift him up, he'll come in. If you give him the glory, he'll come in. If you give him praise, When you praise him, something got to happen. If you praise him, something begins to work in your behalf. When you praise, when you shout, when you glorify him, when you lift him up, just lift him up, lift him up, that all men might see the glory, see the power of God. Yes, lift him up, to all men, that all men might see his wonders, might see his miracles, might see his power. Thank you, Jesus. He got wonders. He has miracles. He does great things. Yes, he does. Just praise him. Praise him. Praise him. No matter what's going on, you gotta praise him. No matter what it looks like, you gotta praise him. No matter what it feels like, you gotta praise him. No matter what's going on, no matter what's going on, just put your trust in the Lord. In the Lord, he will withstand the hands of the avenger. Yes, he will. Yes, praise him. Praise him. Praise him. Praise him. In times of injustice, praise him. In times of distress, praise him. When trouble is all around, praise him. When it seems like the enemy has the best of you, just lift up your hands and give God a praise. And if you can't do anything else, just lift up your hand and wave a praise unto the Lord. Praise him anyhow, anyhow, any way, any fashion, no matter what it is, just shout a praise to him. Your enemy, your foes, the devil that comes up against us, oh yes he can, oh yes he will, he comes to and fro to kill, steal, and destroy, but if you praise the Lord, praise the Lord, praise the Lord, your enemy got to fall, yes Lord.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. All you got to do is praise him. He'll come to your rescue. Hallelujah. If you praise him, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. He will deliver you. He will set you free. In the name of Jesus. Oh, bless his name. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Though we are up against fiery trials and tribulations, although we are up against the works of Satan and his adversaries and his foes, for you said, Lord, in your word that you will still the avenger. In the time and the heat of injustice, we can always look towards you because you are our strength. You are our help. A very present help in the time of trouble. And you, O God, shall shield your people with your glory and within your power. Father, we thank you for your Son. We thank you, Lord, for sending your Son, Jesus, into this world. For it's only he that can heal, he that can deliver, and he that can set free. For you say that if my people whom are called by my name should humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, then will I hear from heaven and I will heal their land. In the midst of confusion, oh God, in the midst of chaos, if we call on your name, you will heal. Yes. Yes, yes, Lord. There are many strides of trouble and catastrophic things that we are experiencing in this day and this time. Hallelujah. But if we should only call on your name is the way of escape. So prepare an open door, a door, oh God, a door that will lead us to refuge, a door that will lead us to your strength, your door, oh God, that will lead us to a place of safety. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. And no matter what the works of the enemy may come up against us, we yet have confidence and believe that you will cause us to triumph over all of our troubles in the name of Jesus. So I ask, Lord, that you would step in now and just touch, fix, resolve the issues of this nation, the issues of our society, the issues of our household, the issues of our communities, the issues of our streets. And Lord, that you would send forth your word as a standard, and that you would rise against the heathen, you would rise against the wicked, you would rise against those that torment, you would rise against the hand and the works of Satan. Hallelujah. For this battle is not ours, Lord, but it belongs to you. And knowing that it belongs to you, Lord, we know that we are already conquerors. We are already conquered. We have conquered this thing. And Lord, you have already caused us to triumph over, hallelujah, every wicked deed. In the name of Jesus. So we seek your face and we request that you, God, would then heal our land, and Lord, that you would heal our hearts and you would calm our fears, and Lord, you would cause us not to be fearful, Lord, for you said that you have not given us the spirit of fear, but a love and a power and of a sound mind. Hallelujah. Ease our mind and our troubles. Ease our sorrows and our pains, Lord. Ease, oh God, those that we have questions to, Lord, that you have already made provision and you have already made a way. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. And in the midst of it all, God, we would then turn our face towards you and we would give you praise and give you glory.
we'll give you honor and we'll lift your name and we'll magnify you. We exalt you and we'll give you honor, for you are our honorable due of all of our praise. Hallelujah. Let us learn to praise you in the midst of every situation and in the midst of every circumstance. Let us learn to praise you when we're weak, and let us learn to praise you when we're saddened, and when we learn to praise you, Lord, when we are, Lord, are doing great in our stride for life. Hallelujah. For praise, Lord, is becoming of us to give you praise, and you inhabit the praises of your people. And within these praise, Lord, you shall rescue your people. And we give you the glory, and we give you the praise. In Jesus' name, thank God, and amen. Hallelujah.
Just entertaining his presence. Hallelujah. The King of Glory is here. Hallelujah. Glory to your name. Glory to your name. Glory to your name. Forever you are the same. We worship and adore you. We bow ourselves before you, giving you the glory that is due your name. Come on, let's worship. Glory to your name. Everybody, come on. Glory to your name. Glory to your name. Forever you are the same. We worship and adore you, bow ourselves before you, giving you the glory that is due your name. Oh, glory to your name. Come on, let's worship. Glory to your name. Glory to your name. Forever you are the same. We worship and adore you. Hallelujah. We bow ourselves before you. Come on. Let's do it one more time. Say glory to your name. You can sing. Come on, you sing. Glory to your name. You sing. Glory. Hallelujah. Forever you are. You are the same. We worship and adore you. Hey, we bow for you, yes, God. Giving you the glory that is due. Let's take it out. We magnify your name. Glorify your name. Hallelujah. Oh, God. Come on, you gotta take some time and give him glory. We magnify your name. Glorify your name. Oh God. There's nobody else like you, Lord. We magnify your name. Johnson, let's play. Come on, let's lift him up. All the worshipers joining in. I know you feel his presence. Come on, right there where you are. Come on, lift him up, lift him up. Oh, we magnify your name. Up right where you are. Come on. Right where you are. Hallelujah in his presence. Hallelujah. Glory, glory, glory.
Bless you, Lord.
Longevity has its place, but I'm not concerned about that now. I just want to do God's will, and he's allowed me to go up to the mountain. And I've looked over, and I've seen the promised land. I may not get there with you, but I want you to know tonight that we as a people will get to the promised land. So I'm happy.
From Martin Luther King to Barack Obama, we've come a long way as a people in our struggle for civil rights. Even with these strides, we still have a long way to go. The fight for social justice continues. As we've made our way from the back of the bus to the front of the bus, social justice battles take on new shapes and forms. We've earned the rights to vote in the 60s, but voter suppression is at an all-time high. It's lent way to courageous leaders like Stacey Abrams to continue the fight on the different battlegrounds of today. Whether past or present, the fight for justice has taken a tremendous amount of courage on the sports field and off. Many have risked their lives, their health, their dreams, and their careers in this battle. Interracial marriage was illegal in certain states up to the 1980s. Who we love should not be limited by race. Our fight includes a fight for economic rights, as well as fighting for our health and the health of our children. The gains that we have made must continue. The fight for justice must go on. After all of this, we still have to take a knee in protest of the continued killing and injustices of today. From Eric Garner to Tamir Rice, to Michael Brown, to Freddie Gray, Sandra Bland, and many, many more. In the face of our greatest adversities, we draw strength from Joshua 1:9. Have I not commanded you? Be strong and courageous. Do not be frightened, and do not be dismayed, for the Lord your God is with you wherever you go. When we continue to be strong and of good courage, as in Joshua 1:9, together we will get to the promised land.
Join us every Thursday from 11 a.m. to 1 p.m. as Ephesians of Richmond feeds the harvest. In partnership with the West Contra Costa County School District and the Contra Costa County Food Bank, Ephesians Community Development Center is distributing healthy meal boxes for families. We have boxes that contain dairy, protein, fruits and vegetables, along with supplemental food boxes of non-perishable goods. Supplies are limited and given out on a first-come, first-served basis. Again, that's every Thursday from 11 a.m. to 1 p.m. We are located in the Richmond Village, and you can pick up your boxes on the corner of South 26th and Cutting Boulevard. You can join in on our virtual worship services on Facebook Live or by subscribing to our YouTube channel, which is Ephesians of Richmond. We invite you to walk through the Bible with us as we present inspiring lessons filled with practical advice for everyday living during our Sunday school. Sunday school takes place at 10 a.m. on Sunday mornings via Zoom. Immediately following Sunday school at 11:30 a.m., we invite you to experience the glory, experience the worship, and experience the praise with us during our virtual morning worship service. The Bible says men ought to always pray, and here at Ephesians, we believe in the power of prayer. Meet us for prayer Monday, Wednesday, and Friday mornings at 7 a.m. on our prayer call. If evenings work better for you, you can join us on Tuesday and Thursday evenings at 6:30 p.m. The number to call in is 669-900-9128. Meeting ID is 723-669-3000. 3539. Can't make it to the prayer call but have a prayer request? You may email us your prayer request at ecogicrca@gmail.com. Again, that's ecogicrca@gmail.com, and we will add your prayer to the list. Join us on Tuesday evenings for Bible study. Whether you're a seasoned Bible scholar or a recent convert to Christ, we invite you to expand your knowledge, feed your faith, and become empowered with sound Bible teachings and the Word of God. Coming soon! Join us as we launch the ECDC Technology Center. This will serve as a no-fee computer technology and training center. Grand opening and ribbon cutting information to follow. If you would like to partner with us here at Ephesians of Richmond and sow a tax-deductible seed into this ministry, we have multiple giving platforms to help you do so. You can go to our webpage at ecogicrca.org and scroll down to the middle of the page where you'll find a link to donate. You may also give via Cash App. Our Cash App ID is $ECOGICRCA. Lastly, you may send your donation to P.O. Box 2950, Richmond, California, 94802. We thank you in advance for supporting the ministries here at Ephesians.